This time we're in sunny, foggy Newfoundland. Just arrived basically last night at around midnight, and gonna be out here on the rock for the next 3 weeks trying to photograph all of the specialties here. So I hope you'll join along with me here and see all the great photography opportunities that Newfoundland has to offer. Alright, here I am in one of the finest spots in Newfoundland. This is called Bonavista. It's an amazing place right over here. We've got a rock where puffins are breeding. They're coming in with fish and diving into their burrows. And all in the bay behind me is tons of humpback whales. It's amazing how many there are. At any given time, you look out there and you can see the spray from between 8 and 10, 12 different whales. Quite a spectacular place. I'm gonna get back at it here, try to get some more shots of these puffins and black guillemots. We'll see you soon. Ecological Reserve, a phenomenal place. I'm talking really loud. I hope you can hear me over the gannets behind me. Anyways, I think there's something like 11,000 pairs of gannets here breeding. They're flying all around. It's pretty much like shooting fish in a barrel. But to get a really amazing shot, that takes something a little extra. So that's what we're working on this morning. There's also tons of kittiwakes, common mirrors, thick-billed mirrors, razor bills, and all kinds of stuff. It's an amazing place. I hope you get to get here one day. Alright, I'm here in Mobile Bay, which is near Whitless Bay on the east coast of Newfoundland. And in behind me here in this bay are absolutely thousands of puffins and murres and gulls that are all coming in to feed on the capelin. Now there's no better way to get out there and photograph them than from the kayak. So that's where I'm off to. We'll see how we go. Alright, ahead, I'm not sure if you can see, but there are hundreds if not thousands of seabirds. There's a little puffin just in front of us. Oh, there he goes. See you later. Anyways, this is the idea. Unfortunately, it's pretty cloudy, so that doesn't really bode well for kayak photography, but we'll see if the weather improves. But in any case, it's a really awesome experience to be out here with all of these seabirds. There goes a common mirror. Keep trying. Alright, here I am, still in Newfoundland, and it is a cloudy day. So I thought I'd take this opportunity to show you just exactly what I brought on this trip. What equipment did I bring? Sort of what's in the bag, so to speak. Now, I guess we should start with the bag itself. What I've got here is a Low Pro Pro Trekker 600. It's a new bag for me. I just got this bag, and I've really enjoyed it so far. It's kind of a monster of a bag. I can fit everything in there, and yet I was able to fly here with it, so still able to get it on the plane. And you can just load this thing full of all kinds of goodies. So let's take a look at what we got in here. Obviously the main thing here, 500 millimeter, 1.4 converter, and 7D. Fits in there, no problem, which is awesome. Couple of flashes. I brought a 500 series flash, 400 series flash just in case I needed it. I never leave home without my 300f4, one of my favorite lenses. I've got my 17 to 40 millimeter lens, bag full of extra batteries, double A's, triple A's, whatever I might need. I have got my backup camera here, which is a Canon 50D, and it's mounted on a 400 5.6, so that's just in case I need that. And I've got my binoculars here, which are Nikon Monarch 10x binoculars. Really good binoculars for the price. They're around $350. And for the quality they are, they're a really good buy. And the final main item I have in here is this little battery pack from Photix, which theoretically you attach that to the flash and it makes the flash recycle faster. Now, I believe it only works at full power or half power flash. So how useful it actually is in the field remains to be seen. And whether or not it makes the batteries last longer in the flash, I'm not sure of that yet either. I just got this item, but so far so good with it. Other things in the bag up here, we've got extra batteries, extra memory cards, a really cool little design here from the memory cards. You can actually flip this over, whether it's empty or full, the card. Circular polarizing filter, better beamer, cleaning kit. Up top here, easy spot to put a laptop, and this bag actually comes with a really nice laptop pouch. You can fit your tripod down in here and carry it, really good design. Waterproof cover. And what I love about this bag is it comes with actually this piece, which is, it can be the top of the bag. It can clip on here, but I love when I'm out in the field, this is perfect just to have a really cool looking fanny pack to put on. And you can fit a ton of stuff in here. I never leave home without my duct tape. I've got my iPod and speakers, granola bar, some bottle of water, more memory cards, extra batteries, whatever you might need. It's all in here. And you look really cool while you're wearing it too. So that's what's in the bag on this trip. And I hope you found that interesting. I'm up here atop Signal Hill overlooking the beautiful city of St. John's, Newfoundland. And today being my last day here in this beautiful province, I thought I'd come up here and take a look down on the city and go for a little bit of a walk. Anyways, I hope you've enjoyed coming along on this video blog here in Newfoundland with me. It's been a fantastic trip filled with lots of good memories, lots of good birds, whales, landscapes, and very, very friendly people here in Newfoundland. So check back often. I'll have more content for you soon. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I'll see you soon. You'll be a bright light coming out of the dark. All the doctors blinking hard. You'll be lightning coming out of the storm. It's a message, it's a I can feel you and what you got.